Hello everyone, this is Captain Yellowfin, and I want to show you some Silent Hunter 3 gameplay. I have the SH3 mod, the Living Silent Hunter 3 2015 edition mod, and our captain is going to be Otto Werner, and we start out in 1939 at the Erprobungsstelle, and then we'll switch over to a Type 7. I think we start out with Type 2A, and then we'll also ask for a transfer to a different flotilla as soon as we return from our first patrol. We'll also switch over to a different boat, to a Type 7. Let's quickly go over the crew and the boat, and then head right out to the first mission. The introductory mission. Let's see. Put all our qualified personnel in here. We have an overview. Let's quickly go over the officers as well. Okay, so we have this guy, mechanic, that's always good. No, it'd be nice to have an engineer. Let's see, we do not have a deck gun on this boat, but we will later. So, why don't we... Switch out we will give this guy the outlook qualification, and we'll 300. They're both. I think he's mechanic is expendable. Although I've just read that the first skill is always the most effective one, so I'd like to keep him. But it's also important to have a good lookout. So, we could send this guy away and give him Walter Lehmann the mechanic qualification once we return from the first patrol. We could send and could change him for this guy. He's a deck gunner / medic / engineer. And he has 500 renown. That's will be good enough to run the engine room. I think that's what I'm gonna do. Well, I like the mechanic, and he has already 300. I don't plan on getting damaged too often, so I'll be okay with that. Having a mechanic here as a second qualification. So let's relieve him and let's get this guy. Okay. Put him right in too. Now we don't even need a full complement here. And he goes here, and this guy goes here, and just on. Okay, now let's look at the NCOs. Okay, he's good. Let's order them then. So 100 out of 150. 80 out of 150, okay. And then what do we have here? 50, 80. 80. And 80. Okay. Let's see what we can get here. Okay, let's get rid of this guy. And get this guy. And what else do we have? And let's get rid of this guy and get this guy. Okay. Let's get rid of this guy. Let's get Konrad Altmaier here. I'll try to remember the names at least at some point. But may take a while. Now we're down to 950. Let's do the same thing with the crew. We'll have to see how far our renown takes us here. I don't think there is any. Well, we can change the torpedo loadout, but we're not going to use any renown to upgrade the boat, so we're gonna do one mission anyway, only with this boat. All right, 20 out of 20. This guy is weak. What do we have here? 25. 25. The weakest link must go first. And what do we have here? A couple of. They don't cost much, so let's get them. I've started the career through SH3 Commander. And this. Tool adds to immersion in a lot of ways, and it also allows me to qualify and promote people at will, which I think is more realistic. One promotion or one qualification only per stay in base is a bit not very much. So that's one thing, and the other thing that Commander, SH3 Commander, allows a player to do is lost my train of thought here. What was it? I don't remember, but it will come back to me. Or something else, something. Anyway, let's get more crew here. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4. We have 4. Simply 2. Let's this guy and this guy. And call it 10. And him. And him. And Alexander Aubrey. Alright. How much we have? 820 left. Can we still upgrade our mates? E? I am going to organize my crew. While on patrol, I'll have the maids preferably stay here in the Ikraum, in this compartment, and the crew over here, so I can quickly find who I'm looking for. And I also have a system of keeping them in order. I'll have the fittest one up top on the left, and the weakest ones, the exhausted ones, in the lower right corner, so I can always get people from up here, and I'll know they are somewhat fit, more fit than these others down here who need to rest. Let's see if we have ordered them. 8, 8, 8. That goes here. Okay, and then we have 200. 200. Right here. Alright, so let's. I think we only need to switch out this guy. Excellent. Alright, I think we are all set. Let's do this. Actually, he goes up here. And we'll have this guy over here. I don't even need one crew member now, but in the engine compartment. That seems satisfactory. The flat guy, I don't think we're gonna use him much. As I usually do not seek to hunt or not hunt, but to actually fight aircraft. Now this is my second attempt at a recorded Let's Play. I abandoned the first one because for various reasons. First, the sound quality was not convincing, and I'm not sure about this one. I'm still trying to find the best setup here for recording, but also my gameplay wasn't very good. I was quite bad at manual targeting, which is what's going to be in this Let's Play as well. Obviously, I play at around 95, 96 realism, 96% it is, and the only two options, we'll see that in a bit, that I'm gonna leave on is, one is the weapons officer, because I'm too lazy to flip through the pages of the recognition book, and the other is obviously for only for the Let's Play, the external camera. But I'm not gonna get any tactical advantages from using the external camera. So I think we're all set here. Now let's take a quick look at the submarine. I really don't think there's anything we can or even want to upgrade. We are... we're going to get an electrical fish here. At least the primary ones. Historically, the steam torps here recognizable at the with the green tip, or and mainly the silver tail, as opposed to the yellow golden tail. These steam torpedoes were used as reserve torpedoes, so I'm usually gonna go with a loadout of mainly electrical torps and a few steam torps. That's at this point the most accurate information I have on historic loadouts. Over here we did the crew. Right, any other upgrades? I don't think we can get. No, we can. Let's get the decal here, and then let's go. So let's take a quick look at the realism settings. Limited battery, fresh air, oxygen, fuel. Obviously, realistic damage model, repair time. Realistic sinking time, sinking duration. From what I've, as I said, this is the second attempt at a recording, but it's not the second career. I've played quite a bit off camera, so to say, and I do not find exactly that the sinking duration is actually realistic, even with this option checked. There's a lot of ships took easily an hour, 2 or 3 hours to sink, especially when they were not flooding at either the bow or the stern. The reason is that when they're sinking, when they're flooding off the center of gravity of the ship, they do not dive into and put the hole, the actual opening in the hull, deeper into the water by that. So that's the physical scientific explanation. And but anyway, we'll obviously leave it on to make it a bit more realistic than the stock game. Manual targeting, and we will use the weapons officer support. If you read up, and it is possible, go to subsim.com and browse, search through the threads. You will find original members have uploaded and linked to original documents of the German Kriegsmarine, targeting manuals, commander manual, and some are original PDF. PDFs of the originals, or copy thereof, and some are translations into English, so it is possible pretty much for anyone to have some pretty good access to original documentation. So when you look at these sources, you will find that actually torpedoing was even more torpedoing a target in World War II for a German submarine crew was even more complex than the manual targeting models here in Silent Hunter 3. And the reason is that, well, first of all, I think the optical problems are modeled very well. They're modeled it's a good game, don't get me wrong, but I think in reality, they at night on the ocean, you would see a lot less, and I think what is very hard for the game to take into account is the fact that for the part of human psychology and physiology, for example, we overestimate, or is it underestimate? Anyway, there is a systematic error in distance estimation at night. I think it's an overestimation. Objects appear smaller at night than they are in reality, which translates to overestimating the distance and other such things, such as waves. I will not have the camera stabilized, but I think there are still some things that are not modeled in the game. For example, also another part is the torpedo Vorhalterechner, the targeting computer, mechanical, electromechanical targeting computer, would break down quite frequently, not only due to enemy action, but also due to wear and tear, seawater entering the boat, spray, and corrosion, consequentially damaging the wires connecting the periscope, which was quite an advanced electromechanical targeting device. I mean, it was connected directly to the torpedo Vorhalterechner, and it's really, the original documentation is very interesting for people with an interest in engineering and mathematics also. And I think the game can only model these problems to an extent. And the other thing is then the commanding, the actual shooting involved a lot of people. It wasn't just one person deciding where and how to shoot. There were many people involved. There was a guy, usually the commander, at the periscope aiming and giving commands, and then there was a guy operating the computer, and then there was at least one other guy setting up the torpedo in the torpedo compartments, either bow or stern, and then there were the people running the boat, basically keeping it at the right depth and on the right course at the right speed, and performing all the maneuvers. Say if a shot misses, then they were ordered to turn the boat around and shoot from the stern, or whatever the tactical situation required of them. And the number of potential sources of error involved in this whole chain of command, in this whole process, is quite big. And I think it was quite a bit harder, even with all these options ticked here, it was even quite a bit harder in reality to actually hit the ship with a torpedo. But for the purpose of this let's go, we're going with this setup.